is Ellie, and I'll be talking about Heartstopper. I like the Netflix series over the comic series of Heartstopper, I think, for two reasons. One, because I'm a little bit biased. I watched the series first, so it's always gonna have like a very special place in my heart. And two, I think it being a TV show makes it a little bit easier to enjoy as a community. Like, of course, if you have a comic book, you can have a book club or something of that sort. But I know that I watch the show a lot, like with my friends and with my sister. It's a show that really brings people together, so I think it's really cool to be able to watch it as a group. And so I think that's one of the advantages of the TV show over the comic. My favorite character is Nick. I just love that kid, to be honest. He's awesome. He's just like a really good guy. And I think you see him go through a lot of hardships, and he doesn't always make the right decisions for sure. But there's something very authentic in the way he's portrayed. I think part of it is because I do see a little bit of myself in Nick as well. He just doesn't really know he's gay, and then he starts getting really close with his best friend, and then he's like, oh crap, and he's looking up the Am I Gay quizzes and stuff like that, and it's just really a confusing time. And I think when I watched the show for the first time, I was kind of like, oh my gosh, I was so embarrassed when I did all of those same things in high school, literally step by step. But maybe it's not quite as weird as I thought it was, because somebody obviously knew it was a universal enough problem to like write a show and a comic series over. And I just think the way they portray that anxiety and confusion, but also like happiness and expression, I think overall they do express that in a really authentic way. Probably my favorite scene is the scene with Nick and his mom towards the very end of season one on Netflix. And Nick told his mom that him and Charlie were more than friends. And I just thought his mom's response was so sweet and gentle. I think they captured Nick's anxiety really well, but also just kind of the response of his mom was just such a good example of empathy and care. And I know every time I watch it with people, all of us are like, it just hits you right in your heart. It's a really sweet, intimate mother-son moment. And yeah, it makes me cry like every time I watch it. There's a couple changes for sure that I noticed between the comic series and the show. One big change is the amount they go into the darker parts of Charlie's mental health. On one hand, like, I do think the comic series, including those darker details, probably was representative of a lot of people and their experiences coming out and just like being queer. However, I can kind of respect the decision to leave those out, just because Heartstopper, it is a show that I wish I could have seen when I was a kid. I know a lot of gay love stories usually just have more adult themes, which makes them less accessible to a younger audience. So I think by omitting those darker parts, even though they might be authentic and even though people might relate to them, by omitting those parts, they made it so more people could enjoy the show. And I think in terms of trade-off, that was probably a good deal. I definitely can and do recommend this series to everyone. I can't really recommend one over the other. I think they're both great. I know I prefer the series, but it's not because the comics are bad. I do think this is a show that everyone should watch, just because it's so real and it's so authentic and relatable for a lot of people. So I think it just does a really good job addressing tension and confusion about topics that are sometimes seen as controversial. So I definitely recommend, and I do to like everyone and anyone.